Hi friends, I am Siva Nikolati from Vyas Medical Academy. Now I want to share with you about the structural organization in animals. This topic deals with the types of animal tissues present in our body. So start with the tissues. These are four types. They are epithelial, connective, and skeletal and neural tissue. Coming to the introduction, generally in unicellular organisms, we find all the functions like respiration and digestion are performed by a single cell. But in the case of multicellular organisms, we find a group of similar cells along with the intracellular substances produce a common function. Such organization is called tissue. Guys, we all must know that a complex body is made up of only four basic types of tissues. These are epithelial, connective, skeletal and neural tissues. So when these tissues are organized in well proportion and pattern, they are used to form organs like heart, kidneys, etc. When two or more functions are performed by a single organ, then they are used to form organ systems like circulatory system, digestive system, etc. So guys, let's go to the topic animal tissues. The first one is the epithelial tissue. These epithelial tissues can be formed on the surface of skin and lining the cavities of body organs. And these act as physical barriers, which means they give protection against pathogens. And these are involved in repair of injuries. And guys, based on the composition of layers, these are divided into two types. They are simple and compound epithelium. Again, based on the shape of the cells, the simple epithelium is divided into three types. They are simple squamous, simple cuboidal, and simple columnar epithelium. Here, the simple squamous epithelium can be arranged as flat with irregular boundaries, and these are commonly found in the walls of blood vessels, air sacs of lungs, and walls of Bowman's capsules of nephron. And the function of this tissue is to form diffusion boundary. And the second one is a simple cuboidal epithelium. This can be generally seen cube-like cells, and this can be found in the walls of ducts and tubular parts of nephrons of kidneys. And guys, we can find microvilli present on their surfaces in proximal convoluted tubule of nephron. And the third one is a simple columnar epithelium. These are of two types. They are non-ciliated and ciliated epithelium. In the inner surface of stomach and intestine, we cannot find cilia present on the surfaces. And we can find microvilli present on the surface, which increase the surface area of absorption. And the second one is a ciliated epithelium. In the inner surface of bronchioles and fallopian tubes, we can find cilia present on the surface. Guys, mark this point because it is came in the NEET 2019 examination. So let's see in detail. In the inner surface of bronchioles and fallopian tubes, we can find cilia present on the surface, which helps to move particles or mucus in a specific direction over the epithelium. So the next one is the compound epithelium. The compound epithelium can be arranged as more than one layer, and we can find these can be appeared as tall and slender cells. And we can find this on the, here some of the columnar and cuboidal cells get specialized to produce some secretions, and they form glandular epithelium. These are unicellular glands and multicellular glands. Unicellular glands are nothing but goblet cells, and these can be found in the alimentary canal. And the second one are the multicellular glands. These are clusters of cells which can form in the salivary glands. On again basis of pouring of the secretions, they are divided into two types. They are exocrine and endocrine. These exocrine glands are provided with ducts and the secret mucus, saliva, arils, and oil products. And next one is the endocrine glands. These are ductless glands and their products are hormones. And again, pouring of the secretions, the exocrine are classified as three types. They are mesocrine, apocrine, and holocrine glands. In pancreas, we can find mesocrine glands, and in mammary glands, we can find apocrine. And in sebaceous glands, we can find holocrine glands. Guys, hope you understand this, and let's go to the next topic, compound epithelium. This compound epithelium can be arranged as more than one layer. And these can act to give protection against chemical and mechanical stresses. This columnar epithelium is known for the mucus secreting goblet cells. And guys, let's go to the next topic, connective tissue. These connective tissues are mesodermal in origin. The special function of this tissue is to connect and linkage all the tissues together. On the basis of the composition of matrix, they are classified into three types. They are loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, and specialized connective tissue. In the loose connective tissue, there are three types of tissues. They are areola, adipose, and reticular tissue. These three tissues are located beneath the skin. Here the areola tissue. These areola tissues provide structural framework to the epithelium, and it contains mostly fibroblasts with many fibers, macrophages, etc. And the adipose tissue. This tissue is specialized to serve to store fat, which means in detail, when excessive nutrients are present in our body which are not used, they are converted into fats and stored in this tissue. And the next one is the reticular tissue. These tissues provide structural framework to the lymphoid organs such as spleen, bone marrow, and lymph nodes. And guys, based on the composition of the matrix and fibers, the dense connective tissue is divided into three types. They are dense regular, dense irregular, and elastic connective tissue. In the dense regular connective tissue, we can find fibers are arranged in regular pattern, and tendons and ligaments come under this dense regular connective tissue. And the next one is the dense irregular. In this, fibers are arranged in irregular pattern. Here we can find many fibroblasts with fibers. And the next one is the elastic connective tissue. Guys, this is very important in NEET examination, so let's concentrate on it. Here the elastic connective tissue is yellow in color, and it has a capability of extension and recoil. It can be commonly found in the walls of arteries, vocal cords, and elastic ligaments between vertebrates. And it contains mucous connective tissue, which is nothing but which connects portal or embryonic stage. And guys, it is very important. The mucous connective tissue can be appeared in the umbilical cords of Watson jelly. I want to repeat it once again. In the umbilical cord of Watson jelly, we can find mucous connective tissue, which comes under the elastic connective tissue. And the next one is the specialized connective tissue. In this, we can find two types of connective tissue. They are skeletal and fluid connective tissue. Bone and cartilages come under this skeletal connective tissue. Here, the bone gives a structural framework to the body. And the next one is the fluid connective tissue, which is nothing but blood. And next, the muscular connective tissue, which is the third type in animal tissue. These are mesodermal in origin. And these the study of muscles is nothing but myology. These muscles give posture to the body. These are of three types. They are skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. Guys, all of you may get confused in this particular topic, so please concentrate it once again. These skeletal muscles, here we can see the structure of skeletal muscle. These are striated in structure, and it contains many nucleus. So these are multinucleated, and they are striated in structure and voluntary in function. These can be found in the biceps of muscle, and these are attached to the skeletal muscle. These skeletal muscles are controlled by the somatic nervous system. And the second one is smooth muscle. Here we can see the structure. They are unstriated in structure, and only one nucleus is present in each fiber. So these are uninucleated. Here, these can be commonly found in the visceral organs, such as elastic ligaments and external genital ducts, vocal cords, etc. And the contraction of the smooth muscles is controlled by the autonomous nervous system. And the third one is the cardiac muscle. These cardiac muscles are striated in structure and involuntary in function. These are controlled by the autonomous nervous system. Here, guys, we can find myocardial cells and myoglobin pigment. Here, myoglobin pigment is nothing but oxygen storing pigment. The cardiac muscle is described as functional sphincter. All of you don't know what is meant by functional sphincter. So let's concentrate on it. Functional sphincter is nothing but the excitation of one myocardial cell leads to the excitation of other myocardial cell to produce a whole heart rate contraction as a single unit. This is to be described as functional sphincter. Here, each myocardial cell is joined to the adjacent myocardial cell by electrical junctions or gap junctions. Guys, these cardiac muscles are the only muscles which can form in our heart. And the next one is the final topic of the animal tissue is the neural tissue. Here, the neural tissue consists of two types of cells. They are neurons and neuroglial cells. 50% of the neural tissue contains neuroglial cells. Guys, here we can see the structure of neuron. It contains nucleus, dendrites, basal granules, cell body, square shell, myelin sheath, node or ronin, and synaptic node. These are electrically excitable cells which conduct and transmit impulses. These are nothing but the functional unit of the neural tissue. And the next, on the basis of processes, these neural tissues are classified into three types, the unipolar, bipolar, and multipolar neurons. The unipolar neurons are nothing but the composition of one axon with one dendrite, which can be commonly found in the embryonic stage. And the next one is the bipolar neurons. These are nothing but the combination of one axon with one dendrite directly coming from the cytosol. These can be commonly found in the retina of our eye. And the third one are the multipolar neurons. These neurons are the combination of one axon with one or more dendrites. Most of the human body consists of these multipolar neurons. And the last and very important topic is neuroglial cells. These neuroglial cells are non-conductive impulse cells. These divide throughout the life cycle, and these provide supportive structure and protect the neural system. The neuroglial cells of the central nervous system contains six types of cells. They are oligodendrocytes, astrocytes, ependymal cells, microglial cells, gland cells, and satellite cells. Here the oligodendrocytes, these form myelin sheath around many axons in the central nervous system. And the next one, the astrocyte cells. These are star-shaped cells, and these are helpful in providing blood-brain barrier. And they form interconnected network between neurons and capillaries. And the third one is the ependymal cells. These are columnar ciliated cells and can be found in the lining of cavities like brain and spinal cord. And the next one, microglial cells. These cells are mesodermal in origin and these are phagocytic cells. Squamous cells. These cells form myelin sheath around many axons in the peripheral nervous system. And the last final one are the satellite cells. These cells form cytons around many ganglions in the peripheral nervous system. Guys, you all may get confused in all these examples, but these examples has more priority in the NEET examination. If you get confused, please concentrate on each function. Then you will get detailed understand where these tissues are located in your body. Hope you guys understand the topic. And finally, Vyas Medical Academy is wishing you all the best for the NEET examination.